El principio de causalidad y el hecho de que el principio de causalidad sea inviolable es un verbo.
¿Quién? Uno ve la familia, por ejemplo, está generando todos los valores de la familia, está el tema de las tradiciones. Le vimos con vergüenza el domingo como un.
Es un buen argumento a favor del teísmo o del deísmo.
¿Como una cortina, una cortina oscura?
No.
Dígame si no. Hola.
Hello. I cannot hear you.
Hello, my friend.
Yes, do you hear me? Tana, do you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yes. You look very smart, my friend.
Are you sure, my friend?
Are you going with me and Data alone to Hollywood?
That's... Actually, that's a very good idea.
It is actually. Nowadays, I don't think that those people who work there are doing badly. Because you see many people are indoors, so they watch TV more than ever. I think they're doing very well.
Yes, my friend.
It's the right opportunity for us to go there, Chanamas.
Yeah, my friend. And how was your day so far?
I'm all right. In the morning, Chanavas was there with me. Yeah. He's very friendly. He's very small. He's somewhere playing around. And well, that is the situation. How is the family?
Yeah, my friend. Everything is fine here. No problem so far. Everything is fine.
Your mom is all right?
Yeah, my friend, she's fine. Everything's fine for her.
And what about the family, Charlie and your father and so on?
Yeah, my friend, they are also fine. They are doing really good. And very happy to meet you after a long time, my friend.
Well, yes, you look just the same.
Yeah, my friend.
Well, I thought you were a lot older. What did you do actually to look younger?
My friend, just eat and sleep. Best thing you can do, my friend.
Well, to be honest, that is a good thing to do, eh?
Yeah, my friend. yeah.
So yes, well, it's a pleasure and this opportunity to introduce to the audience Dr. Chanabachara Chayahan. It's a rather complicated surname to pronounce. She's going to give a talk on investigation of RGO-based nanocomposite for efficient photocatalytic degradation of organic pollutants in wastewater. I think it's a long title, but Dr. Chanama is going to explain the meaning of this and, well, what he has done in this subject for a rather long time, actually. Dr. Chanavas won his PhD at Periyar University in India. I think it's Tamil Nadu. That is the state. And his supervisor is here, is Professor P.N. Ambarasam. Honestly, I know very well Dr. Chanavas. He's a very young fellow. He's about 26, 27 years old, no older than that. And his name is already in about 41 publications. And he has done a great job. He's a very hard worker, a very good friend. And I think the most important thing, he's a very good son. He has a great family. And perhaps that is the most important value he has, to be a good son and to honor his parents and his family and his friends. Now, I can say that because he was at home in my place for about 10 months. So I know him very well. Well, it's funny to say Dr. Chanava, but and that is the real name. You are more than welcome. And thank you very much for accepting this invitation to deliver this webinar. And please, the kid is yours. And we're going to be silent, so you can start at any moment.
Yes, Professor, and thank you so much for your fantastic introduction. I'm really happy that you are introducing me in such a beautiful way. Thank you so much for that. And I want to know whether could you be able to see my slides? Could you be able to see my screen?
Well, you have to share the screen first.
Yes, actually, I'm sharing.
I see nothing actually. I see your face, my face, Carlo's face.
Yes.
You must go to a Chanava presentation, I think.
Yeah.
There we are. Now we are fine.
Yes, Professor. I think now it's fine.
I don't know if people can read well.
Yes.
You can, Carlo, Professor Ambarasam?
Yes, it's okay. It's okay.
Yeah, that's lovely.
Yes, yes.
Oh,
visible.
Now we're going to see.
Slide is visible.
Yes, yeah. Professor. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Right.
Yes, Professor. Thank you.
Well,
I'm Shatavas from Department of Physics, Periyar University. And I'm going to present a part of my research work, which is entitled as Investigation on RGO-based nanocomposites for efficient photocatalytic degradation of organic pollutants in wastewater. I did this work under the complete guidance of Professor P. M. Anbarasan, who guided me towards a path of success in this wonderful research. I did my Doctor of Philosophy work under Professor P.M. Anbarasan. He's an excellent supervisor, and he led me towards a very beautiful way in my life. Thank you so much for that. Yeah. Outline of my presentation. Introduction, high efficient catalytic degradation of tetracycline and ibuprofen using visible light driven novel copper bismuth titanate reduced graphene oxide nanocomposite, and study on its kinetics, intermediates and mechanisms. And the third chapter deals with the computational guided synthesis of reduced graphene oxide, ferric oxide and graphite carbon nanostructure with improved separation and transportation efficiency for degradation of pharmaceutical molecules. And fourth chapter deals with the development of
active. Slide is not moved.
To be able to see my slides?
Yeah, the first one.
The first one, right. Yeah, now is the second.
Yes.
Now it's working.
Is it working now?
Yes. And my dear friend, you know I love you a lot. Speak more slowly.
Hmm. Yeah.
You really like to the moon, actually.
Yeah.
And you want to impress me? I'm already impressed. Okay, let's go.
Yeah. Would you able to see my slide?
Yes. Give more pause when you are going for next slide. Slowly.
It may be due to internet connection, I think so. Yes, Professor. And now it will be fine. And the fifth chapter deals with the development of high efficient cobalt oxide, bismuth oxide, and reduced graphene oxide nanocomposite for an enhanced effective photocatalytic degradation of pharmaceutical molecules with improved interfacial charge transferability. And the final chapter deals with the summary and conclusion. Organic pharmaceutical pollutions. Could you see my third screen? Is it visible now?
No,
it does not move for some reason. Take it easy, we have the time, so.
Yes. The third one. Yes.
Please do start again with the first slide. So not to lose the.
I think now it's visible.
Now what I can see is organic pharmaceutical pollutants. This is
right. Right?
Yeah. Now third slide visible.
Yes, Professor. And could you please give me time? I'm going to change the settings. I'm sorry for the interruption.
No, don't you worry.
Yeah.
Just take your time. We have time to do things properly. Don't worry.
I think now it will be fine. There will be no problem now.
Yes, now we are in the right position. That
yes.
You have to start from the very beginning. Well, this is organic pharmaceutical pollutants.
Organic pharmaceutical pollutants.
Yes.
Organic pharmaceutical pollutants, especially these organic pollutants, especially in pharmaceutical industries and textile industries, has causing a major source of water pollution. Almost 60% of these pollutants were discharged to the water resources without any proper purification process. These organic pollutants were affecting the human life as well as animal and aquatic life by causing various different types of diseases. And so it is mandatory to remove these pollutants from those water resources in order to secure those aquatic animals as well as aquatic plants and also human beings. There are several techniques available, such as liquid-liquid separation, membrane filtration, and reverse osmosis techniques. But these techniques require a huge amount of energy, and the cost required for to use these techniques is really, really high. In addition to that, the recyclability of this technique is very low. And so, in order to overcome these difficulties, we have to go for a green technique which consumes less energy as well as very low cost. the one of the best technology which is available to undergo this, to overcome these difficulties, advanced oxidation process. In this advanced oxidation process, we use catalytic materials to degrade the organic pollutants. Catalyst. Catalyst is nothing but which enhance the rate of reaction, and photocatalyst is nothing but which enhance the rate of reaction in presence of light. It is similar to the photosynthesis in a plant, where it absorbs the sunlight and it produces energy. It is photocatalyst is similar to that. In photocatalytic nanostructures, when light falls on the photocatalytic nanostructures, the electrons from the valence band will get excited to the conduction. Those excited electrons will undergo reduction process to produce superoxide radicals, and the holes produced on the valence band will undergo oxidation process to produce hydroxyl radicals. These superoxyl radicals and hydroxyl radicals will act as active species which undergo degradation process of organic molecules, where the organic molecules will break down continuously until forming some non-toxic minerals as well as carbon dioxide and hydrogen dioxide and water. There are several type of photocatalyst is that. Semiconductor oxide photocatalyst, semiconductor sulfate photocatalysis, and MOFs, and those kind of materials. In our research, we majorly concentrated on the metal oxide semiconductor photocatalyst, where the semiconductor-based photocatalyst is found to be most efficient candidate for an advanced oxidation process. Due to its excellent band gap energy and feasible techniques to synthesis deep metals. This metal oxide can be easily synthesized by various chemical and physical techniques. And in addition to that, the formation of metal oxide composites is also very easy during the metal oxide phases when compared to other materials like MOFs or sulfide, something like that. But this semiconductor photocatalyst has some limitations, like a bandage position of the semiconductor photocatalyst. For a photocatalyst, a better candidate to degrade organic pollutants, it should have an appropriate bandage position, where the valence bandage and conduction bandage of these photocatalytic material, which should be appropriate, that it should not, it should be able to produce a reactive species as efficient as possible. The band gap energy of the semiconductor photocatalyst. The band gap energy plays a major role on the efficiency of the photocatalytic material, where the band gap energy decides the amount of light which it gets absorbed during the photocatalytic process. The efficiency of the photocatalytic material will be directly proportional to the amount of light it is absorbing, and it is converting to excite the electron from valence band to conduction. Photo-excited charge separation and transportation efficiency. This photo-excited charge separation and transportation efficiency plays major role on the efficiency of photocatalytic material, that it decides the rate of production on reactive species. When the photo-excited charge separation and transportation efficiency is higher, the production of active species will be higher. As we saw before, in the photocatalytic mechanism, when the electron transfer from valence band to conduction band, those excited electrons will undergo oxidation process. And so it requires some time to undergo oxidation process. And so the photo-excited separation and transportation efficiency should be higher to achieve that goal. These are the strategies to construct better photocatalyst. In order to construct a better photocatalyst, the photocatalyst should have a high photoresponsiveness ability, improving photoinsulated induced charge separation and transportation efficiency and formation of oxygen vacancies in photocatalyst by doping and compositing and trapping of photoinduced charge carriers to reduce recombination rate and constructing photocatalyst with appropriate bandage positions and the photocatalytic materials with highly reactive catalytic surface. Graphene. Graphene is a king of materials where it's a two-dimensional allotrope of carbon. In the carbon family, like a fullerene nanotube, the graphene is a two-dimensional material. The graphene is consists of a single sp2 carbon atoms with the three adjacent carbon atoms attached in honeycomb-like structure, where these graphene sheets will be in a two-dimensional structure. Advantages of graphene. Graphene has a very good optical transparency, and so it will not screen the light which will get absorbed on the metal oxide nanostructure. And it has a high thermal conductivity, and it has an excellent affinity towards the other metal oxide. And so this graphene sheet can accommodate the maximum number of metal oxides on its surface. It has a superior electron mobility, and so the trapping of photoexcited electrons will be higher in the graphene sheets, as well as it has a very large surface area, and so the accommodation of metal oxides on its surface will also be very, very high. The scope of our research. Preparation of reduced graphene oxide based nanocomposite with metal or metal oxide semiconductors like copper, bismuth titanate, ferric oxide, graphitic carbon, cobalt oxide, titanium dioxide, and bismuth dioxide. Evaluation of structural morphology, optical and photocatalytic properties of this prepared nanocomposite, and examination of photocatalytic degradation ability of prepared nanocomposite against organic pharmaceutical pollutants. And the most important part is investigation on its photocatalytic on the photocatalytic mechanism of prepared nanostructure to understand the interfacial photoexcited charge transfer process. Chapter 2. Could you be able to see this slide, Professor?
Yes, very well.
Yes. It's a chapter 2.
Yes. High efficient catalytic.
Yeah. Chapter 2 deals with the high efficient catalytic degradation of tetracycline and ibuprofen molecules using a visible light driven novel copper bismuth titanate reduced graphene oxide nanocomposite and study on its kinetics, intermediates, and photocatalytic mechanism. Synthesis of copper bismuth titanates and reduced graphene oxide nanocomposite. This novel hybrid ternary nanocomposite was synthesized using simple solvothermal method, where initially the bismuth titanate nanostructure is synthesized by using a bismuth and titanium precursor by simple solvothermal technique, and then copper nanoparticles were deposited on the surface of bismuth titanate nanostructures, and then after the production of this copper bismuth titanate binary nanostructure, the reduced graphene oxide is encapsulated by simple self-assembly process, where pH of the binary nanostructure is adjusted to the positive and the pH of reduced graphene is adjusted to the negative, which is acidic and alkaline. When we mix both the solution during the neutralization process, both the nanostructures will attach to each other to form a encapsulated ternary nanocomposites. Characterization of ternary nanocomposite, where this produced ternary nanocomposite is characterized with XRD analysis as well as a FTR, FESEM, TEM, XPS, UVDRS analysis. And then the photocatalytic properties of a synthesized ternary nanocomposite is analyzed by using ibuprofen and tetracycline molecule as a model pollutants during photocatalytic experiment. Structural analysis of synthesized pristine binary and ternary nanocomposite were conducted by using the XRD analysis, where this X-ray diffractograph of ternary nanocomposite clearly shows the presence of XRD peak of both copper and bismuth titanate nanoparticles. And it clearly shows the formation of ternary nanocomposite. In addition to that, the peak at 15 is the peak nearly at 24 is responsible for the reduced graphene oxide nanosheets. And it clearly shows the formation of ternary nanocomposite. And the XRD spectrograph shows that the formed bismuth titanate nanostructure is a cubic in structure which well agrees with the JCPDS card number 320118. And addition to that, the copper nanoparticles is also in cubic structure, which well agrees with the JCPDS number 040836. And it clearly shows that formation of highly crystalline and fierce fuel nanostructures. Functional group analysis. The functional group present on the surface of nanostructures is analyzed by using a FTIR analysis, but it clearly shows that the vibration at 811 centimeter inverse clearly shows that the binding of pristine nanostructure with reduced graphene oxide nanosheets. And it clearly shows the formation of ternary nanocomposite, as well as the bond between the metal, oxygen, and carbon is clearly identified and clearly confirmed by using the wave number at 1632. And the presence of metal oxide is confirmed by using the transmission peak at 420 to 650. And it clearly shows the formation of ternary nanocomposite, as well as the well binding of metal oxide nanostructure with the two-dimensional nanostructures. Morphological characterization. The morphological properties of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite were analyzed by using a SEM and TEM analysis, where in TEM analysis, the formation of highly crystalline bismuth titanate nanostructure is confirmed by using the TEM analysis, where we can clearly see the lattice pattern in the bismuth titanate nanostructure. And in the figure D and E, the deposition of copper nanoparticles and bismuth titanate nanoparticles on the surface of the reduced graphene oxide sheets is also clearly visible, and it confirms the formation of ternary nanocomposites with well binding between two-dimensional reduced graphene oxide nanostructures and other metal oxides. And the encapsulation of these nanostructures is also confirmed by using a HRTEM analysis of ternary nanostructures, which is shown in the figure C and D, where you can clearly see that encapsulated metal oxide nanostructures by two-dimensional reduced graphene oxide nanostructures. Elemental analysis. The purity of asynthesized ternary nanostructures were confirmed by using the elemental analysis, where the EDAX analysis shows that the presence of elements in asynthesized ternary nanocomposite. And it clearly shows that no other element is present in this material. And so the formation of phase fuel and element pure ternary nanostructure is confirmed. Chemical state analysis. The chemical state of the surface chemical state of a synthesized ternary nanocomposite were analyzed by using an X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy. It clearly shows that the formation of bismuth 3 plus element, which is responsible for higher generation of reactive species. And in the figure F, in the survey spectra, which is a figure A, it clearly shows the presence of all the elements which we expect to be there, like titanium, bismuth, copper, oxygen, and carbon. In addition to that, the figure E and F shows the confirms the binding of metal or metal with the oxygen as well as metal with the surface of produced graphene oxides. And it further confirms the formation of terminated nanotubes. UBDR spectrum. For a heavy efficient photocatalytic nanostructure, it should have a high efficient absorption of a visible light region in the electromagnetic spectrum. There, the UV visible diffuse reflection spectroscopy graph clearly shows that the ternary nanocomposite is able to absorb the visible light region in the electromagnetic spectra, and so the efficiency of the photocatalytic nanostructure will also be very high. There, the band gap energy of a synthesized ternary nanostructures were calculated by using the tau plot, where the tau plot clearly shows that the ternary nanocomposite with lowest band gap of about with a better band gap of 2.79 electron volt, which is able to absorb a very higher amount of visible light region in electromagnetic spectrum. Photocatalytic evaluation. The photocatalytic examination of a synthesized ternary nanostructures is evaluated by using tetracycline and ibuprofen as a model pollutants, where it clearly shows that after 90 minutes of photocatalytic degradation experiment, almost 90% of these pollutants got degraded. And it clearly shows the high efficient nature of our ternary nanocomposite. And we also examined the photocatalytic ability of a pristine and binary nanostructures. In addition to that, we compared the efficiency with the commercial P250A02 nanostructures. And it clearly shows that when compared to the commercial material, our ternary nanocomposite shows a very high catalytic degradation efficiency. Trapping experiment. The trapping experiment is conducted in order to find the predominant reactive species involved during the photocatalytic degradation process. And in this, during the trapping experiment, we used benzoquinone as a superoxide radical suppressor and TEOA as a hole suppressor and IPA, which is an isopropyl alcohol, as a hydroxyl suppressor. We used to add this separate suppressor in this three different separate experiments. While adding benzoquinone, we can find that there is a huge suppression in the degradation efficiency. And it clearly shows that superoxide radicals play a major role on the degradation experiment. And it shows that superoxide radicals is the predominant reactive species which is involving during the photocatalytic degradation reaction process for this ternary nanostructure which we prepared. For proposed photocatalytic mechanism. based on the band gap energy of a synthesized ternary nanocomposite, the banded positions like a valence band and conduction band of banded position of a nanocomposite is calculated, and it clearly shows that the band conduction band edge position of a bismuth titanate is well above the energy required for the production of O2 radicals. In addition to that, the electrons which get excited from the valence band to conduction band of bismuth titanate nanostructures will get excited on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanosheet, as well as it will be transferred to the copper nanoparticles due to their appropriate band positions. When these electrons get trapped by both these copper nanoparticles as well as reduced graphene oxide nanosheets, the production of reactive species will be very high, as we discussed before. This trapping of these electrons will enhance the separation and transportation efficiency of water-excited charge carriers, and so the production of reactive species will also be very high. Conclusion for this chapter. In the current work, the novel copper bismuth titanate and radiographic oxide hybrid photocatalysis was successfully prepared by following a simple hydrothermal method, where UVDRS analysis revealed that copper bismuth titanate reduced graphite oxide ternary nanocompo is highly active within the visible region. And the deposition of copper nanoparticles on bismuth titanate nanoparticles was analyzed and confirmed by using a HRTM analysis. The photocatalytic degradation ability of as prepared pristine binary and ternary nanocomposite was investigated in detail by using a ibuprofen and tetracycline as a reference for pharmaceutical contamination. The analysis of the obtained results suggests that copper nanoparticles of the reduced graphene oxide sheets are playing a major role in the photocatalytic degradation ability of a ternary nanocomposite. From the trapping experiment, it is confirmed that superoxide radicals plays a major role on the degradation of organic pollutants in our ternary nanocomposites. Chapter 3. The chapter 3 is similar to the chapter 1, where it deals with the computational guided synthesis of reduced graphene oxide Fe2O3 and GC3N4 nanostructure with improved charge separation and transportation efficiency for degradation of pharmaceutical molecules. Similarly, this ternary nanocomposite is synthesized using a simple hydrothermal technique where melamine is used as a precursor to synthesize graphite carbon nanostructures, and ferric nitride is used to synthesize the Fe2O3 nanostructure. Initially, this Fe2O3 nanostructures is well embedded on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanosheets by simple hydrothermal technique followed by the thermal pyrolysis at 550 degrees Celsius for 5 hours. And then the reduced graphene oxide is well binded with this binary Fe2O3 and graphite carbon nanosheets by using a simple hydrothermal technique at 200 degrees Celsius for 2 hours to form a well embedded Fe2O3 nanostructures on the surface of graphite carbon sheet, as well as the deposition of reduced graphene oxide with this binary nanostructure. This synthesis technique gives us a wonderful way to synthesize a well-bound ternary nanostructure, and so the separation and transportation efficiency will also be very high. Characterization of ternary nanocomposite. The ternary asynthesized nanocomposite is characterized by XRT, FAR, FSM, XPS, UVDRS, and IDAX analysis, and its photocatalytic properties were analyzed by using a tetracycline molecule as a model organic pollutant. Structural analysis. The structural analysis of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite were analyzed by using the XRD analysis, where the ternary nanocomposite shows the presence of both Fe2O3 and reduced graphite carbon nanosheets. And it also shows that highly crystalline nature of ternary nanocomposite. At 27.7, at the 27.7 degree, you can see the presence of huge peak, which clearly shows the presence of a reduced graphene oxide in the ternary nanocomposite. It confirms the formation of ternary nanocomposite. The functional group of as-synthesized ternary nanocomposite were analyzed by using FPR analysis, where it clearly shows that the formation of a binding between the metal and carbon and oxygen binding, At 1,650 to 1,350 centimeter inverse, and in addition to that, the formation of metal oxide bonding is clearly observed at the 500 centimeter inverse. Morphological characteristics. The formation of such highly dense thinner GC3 nano sheets is due to the thermal oxidation isolation at 550 degrees Celsius of bulk GC3 L4 nanostructure. And the SEM analysis clearly showed that the well embedment of the binary Fe2O3 nanostructures on the surface of reddish graphene oxide sheets. The two-dimensional sheet like graphite carbon can effectively restrain the recombination of photo-induced charge carriers by shortening its vertical movement distance. It means the two-dimensional structure can trap the huge amount of electrons from the photo-absorbing material like Fe2O3 nanostructures in order to enhance the production of reactive species like OH radical and superoxide radicals. The purity of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite is confirmed by using a elemental analysis like a EDAX analysis as well as mapping analysis. And EDAX analysis shows the formation of expected elements, presence of expected elements in ternary nanocomposite, and as well as the presence of elements is also confirmed by using the mapping analysis. HRTEM analysis. In the HRTEM analysis, we can clearly see that good embedment of Fe2O3 nanoparticles in the graphite carbon matrix, and it is clearly visible in 4FC nanostructure is shown in figure B. This confirms the formation of tightly embedded Fe2O3 GC3 N4 nanostructures. The interaction between metal oxide and GC3 N4 will highly increase by the embedding the metal oxide in GC3 N4 nanostructure than the deposition of the metal oxide in the surface of GC3 N4. It means the embedded of light absorbed material with reduced graphene oxide will give a huge way for the highly trapping of photo excited electron, which enhance the photo excited charge separation and transportation efficiency of photo excited electrons, and so the efficiency will also vary. The embedment of Fe2O3 nanostructure in GC3 N4 nanosheet will effectively increase the photon excited charge separation and transportation efficiency from Fe2O3 to GC3 N4 nanostructures and vice versa. The formation of 4FC3G nanocomposite with Fe2O3 nanoparticle packed between GC3 N4 and RG1 nanosheets. The such close contact between Fe2O3 nanoparticles and nanoparticles embedded with the GC3 N4 with RGO will further trap the excited electrons from Fe2O3 nanoparticles. The formation of such closely stacked two-dimensional structures will sufficiently interact with each other in a face-to-face way results in which the formation of huge effective hydrogen-sen interface can be achieved. Chemical state analysis. The chemical state analysis clearly shows the formation of ternary nanocomposite where in the figure C, it shows that the binding of nitrogen atoms with carbon atoms, it shows the formation of two-dimensional GC3 N4 nanostructure, as well as the presence of binding energy peak at 710.7 for Fe2P element. Clearly shows the formation of binding between Fe and oxygen elements, and so it confirms the formation of metal oxide synthesized UVD aspect and tau. Initially, what we did is we tried to optimize the amount of Fe2O3 nanoparticles as well as reduced graphene oxide nanostructures in the ternary nanocomposite to find exactly what amount of Fe2O3 nanostructures is required to produce a huge efficiency in ternary nanocomposite. And we finally found that 4% of Fe2O3 nanostructures on the 3% of GC reduced graphene oxide nanosheets with GC3 and 4 nanostructure gives a very good visible light absorption ability, where the absorption, visible light absorption age were absorbed for 597 nanometer in the absorption in the electromagnetic spectra. It clearly shows that the ternary nanocomposite has an higher ability to absorb a huge amount of visible light region. In addition to that, the band gap energy of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite, pristine and binary nanostructures were analyzed using a tau plot, and it clearly shows that the binary nanostructure for Fe2O3 with GC3N4 has a band gap energy of about 2.8 electron volt, where while the adding 3% of reduced graphene oxide, the band gap energy is reduced to 1.82 electron. And it clearly shows that the addition of reduced graphene oxide as well as the presence of 4% Fe2O3 on reduced graphitic carbon nanosheet has a very low band gap energy. And so the absorption of visible light will also be very, very high. Photocatalytic evaluation. The photocatalytic properties of these synthesized nanostructures were evaluated against tetracycline molecules, and it clearly shows that the 100% of these molecules were degraded within 40 minutes in the 40 minutes of experiment, in photocatalytic experiment. And it clearly shows that 4% of reduced Fe2O3 nanoparticles on GC3N4 nanostructure with 3% of reduced graphene oxide nanosheets has a very high photocatalytic degradation efficiency, which is about 100% of pollutants were degraded in 40 minutes of time. It is really a huge achievement. And the as before, we tried to analyze which is the major reactive species involving the photocatalytic degradation process for our nanostructures. And it also clearly shows that the formation of superoxide radicals is very high. And in addition to that, the superoxide radicals play a predominant role in the degradation of organic pollutants when compared to the hydroxyl radicals as well as holes. The production of hydroxyl radicals is also confirmed, and it also quantitatively analyzed by using the simple terephthalic acid experiment, which is shown in the figure B. Initially, the terephthalic acid is a non-luminescent. When it reacts with the hydroxyl radicals and it forms a hydroxyterephthalic acid, which is highly luminescent in nature. In this photocatalytic reaction process, we added a terephthalic acid during the reaction. And during the reaction, the hydroxyl radicals, which are generated by the ternary nanocomposite, will get reacted with this terephthalic acid to form a hydroxyterephthalic acid, which is luminescent in nature at 430 nanometers. And it clearly confirms the formation of hydroxyl radicals in our ternary nanostructures. Proposed photocatalytic mechanism. The photocatalytic mechanism of synthesized ternary nanostructures is scrutinized by calculating its valence band and conduction band edge position, where it clearly shows that the valence band position of GC3N4 is well above the conduction band of Fe2O3 nanostructure. And it clearly shows that when this ternary nanostructure absorbs absorb light, the electron from the valency band of Fe2O3 nanostructure will get excited to the conduction band. Those excited conduction band electrons will undergo oxidation process to produce reactive species, as well as those excited electrons will not undergo recombination rapidly, where these excited electrons will get trapped on the valence band of GC3 input. It means the recombination rate of these photogatly electrons will drastically got affected. And due to this huge effect in a recombination rate, the time for the production of OH radicals and the superoxide radicals will also be very high. And in other hand, the electrons which is transferred from the valence band over the conduction band of GC3 and 4 nanostructure will also undergo oxidation process. In addition to that, those excited electrons will get trapped on the Fermi level of RGO nanosheets. And it clearly shows that the excited electrons will not undergo recombination process directly, where these excited electrons will get trapped by RGO two-dimensional nanostructure. And due to this trapping, the recombination rate will be very low, as and so the production of OH radicals and superoxide radicals will also be very high. Conclusion. In summary, series of visible light driven Fe2O3, binary Fe2O3 GC3 C3 N4 nanostructure and ternary to RGO Fe2O3 GC3 N4 nanocomposite has been well designed and successfully prepared through two-step hydrothermal technique. The structural, morphological, and optical and elemental properties of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite is also confirmed using the various analysis, which confirms the formation of 2D, 3D, 2D heterojunction with a strong interaction between 3D, 2D Fe2O3, GC3 and 4 binary nanostructure and 2D RGO nanosheets. The photocatalytic properties of as prepared 3D, 2D and 2D, 3D, 2D heterojunction were studied well against the degradation of emerging pharmaceutical contaminations like tetracycline and ciprofloxacin molecules. The photocatalytic mechanism of heterojunction between two-dimensional, three-dimensional or two-dimensional nanostructures was proposed based on UVDRS analysis and the reactive species trapping experiment. This research work provides a new path for the design and production of a heterojunction photocatalyst with supreme charge carrier separation and migration ability. Chapter 4 deals with the development of visible light active cobalt oxide, titanium dioxide, and reduced graphene oxide nanocomposite with effective suppression of charge carrier recombination for efficient pharmaceutical molecule degradation. Synthesis of cobalt oxide, titanium dioxide, and reduced graphene oxide ternary nanostructure. In this synthesis process, initially the cobalt oxide nanostructure is synthesized by using a simple solvothermal technique, and then the previously synthesized ternary synthesized TiO2 nanoparticles were successfully deposited on the surface of cobalt oxide nanostructure by using simple solvothermal reaction technique. And then the ternary nanostructure is prepared by a simple self-assembly process where the surface charge of reduced graphene oxide is adjusted to the alkaline by changing the pH of reaction solution of a reduced graphene oxide into a 10 pH 10, and the surface of a binary nanostructure of a CO3O4 and TiO2 is adjusted to the acidic by changing the pH of reaction solution at pH is equal to 3. during the self-assembly process, when we mix both these pH adjusted solution, during the neutralization process, the reddish graphene oxide sheets will be well bound with the binary CuO3O4 and TaO2 nanostructure, where this binary nanostructure will get deposited on the surface of reddish graphene oxide. Almost we can say that it's a well embedment of those binary nanostructures on the surface of two-dimensional nanostructures. The produced ternary nanocomposite is examined using the same analysis which we discussed before, and the structural analysis clearly shows that the formation of ternary nanocomposite, that it clearly shows the presence of a diffraction peaks of both TiO2 and CuO3O4 nanostructure, and the presence of a diffraction peak of a reduced graphene oxide reduced graphene oxide nanosheets is also confirmed with the peak at 27.7 degree, and it clearly shows that the well embedment of TiO2 and CuO3O4 nanostructure on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanosheets. And in addition to that, this structural XRD analysis clearly shows the highly crystalline nature of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite. Functional group analysis and morphological characterization. The morphological properties of asynthesized ternary nanocomposite were analyzed using a FSM and HRTM analysis, where the FSM micrographs of the 6C4TG ternary nanocomposite clearly show the formation of well aggregated 3D CO3O4 and TeO2 nanocomposite on the surface of 2D RgO nanosheets. The formation of such well aggregated 3D nanoparticles on the surface of 2D sheets will promote the tight interaction between 3D nanoparticles and 2D reduced graphene oxide nanosheets. Such tight surface interaction between these nanostructures will successively increase the electron hole pair separation and transportation process. And so the production of reactive species also very high. The occurrence of high separation and transportation reaction process will effectively increase the reactive species generation ability of a ternary nanocomposite, which will successively increase the photocatalytic organic molecule removal process. The deposition of TD nanoparticles on the surface of crumbled sheet-like RGO with consistent wrinkles and folds on the surface of 2D nanostructures were observed in the HRTM analysis. Such deposition on the surface of 3D cobalt oxide nanoparticles and 3D cobalt oxide and titanium dioxide nanoparticles on the surface of 2D RgO nanosheets has clearly shown the higher interaction between 3D and 2D heterostructures and such higher interaction is due to the surface charge enrichment in both 3D and 2D nanostructures occurred during the hydrothermal synthesis process. The average particle size of 3D cobalt oxide and 3D titanium dioxide nanoparticles were found to be 80 nanometer and 20 nanometers respectively. Chemical state analysis, the chemical composition and the surface binding states of the elements in ternary nanocomposite were analyzed using HR high resolution XPS analysis. The XPS survey spectrum clearly confirms the presence of elemental cobalt, titanium, carbon, and oxygen elements, which correspond to the strong XPS binding energy peaks observed at 780 electron volt, 459, 284.5 and 531.6 electron volt respectively for cobalt, titanium, carbon, and oxygen elements. The couple of high intense peaks were observed at 780.38 electron volt and 795.37 electron volt. These binding energy peaks corresponded to the cobalt, 2p3/2 and cobalt 2p1/2 elemental n/2 respectively. The presence of a higher concentration of CO3 plus species, cobalt 3 is 3 plus species in CO3O4 will considerably increase the active species generation process, and it results in the effective improvement in the photocatalytic reactive species generation process. The interaction and binding between 3D binary metal oxide and 2D reduced graphite nanosheets were further examined and studied by using the high resolution XPS spectrographs of spectrograph of carbon atom, UVDRS and tau plaque analysis. It shows that in the UVDRS analysis, it clearly shows two typical distinct photon absorption bands at the range of 300 nanometer to 450 nanometer and 600 nanometer to 750 nanometer in pristine cobalt oxide nanostructures. And these separate two band absorption band is due to the two photon absorption ranges were attributed to the DD transition of cobalt 3 plus and cobalt 2 plus metal ions in the octahedral and tetrahedral coordination spheres respectively. During the addition of 60% of cobalt oxide and 40% of titanium dioxide in 0.5 gram of reduced graphene oxide, the maximum visible light absorption is observed when compared to the other composition. Besides, the presence of reduced graphene oxide in the ternary nanocomposite is also increased the photon absorption ability significantly, and it can be credited to the addition of two-dimensional RGO nanosheets in ternary nanostructures. And the band gap energy of as prepared pristine and composite nanostructures were found to be 3.25, 1.62, and 1.80, 1.77, 1.75, and 1.78 respectively for the series of pristine and ternary nanostructures. Here we can clearly observe that the presence of 60% of cobalt oxide with 40% of titanium dioxide in 0.5 gram of reduced graphene oxide has a very high visible light absorption ability as well as very low band gap energy. And so the efficiency of the degradation is also very high, will be very high. The photocatalytic examination. The photocatalytic properties of pristine and ternary nanostructure were examined by using tetracycline and ibuprofen molecules as a model pharmaceutical organic pollutants, where it clearly shows that the presence of this ternary nanostructure composite can degrade the almost 100% of these organic pollutants in 70 minutes of reaction time. And it clearly shows the high efficient photocatalytic degradation reaction nature of ternary nanostructures, and the reduction in the band gap of photocatalytic material will effectively increase the visible light absorption ability of ternary nanocomposite. Besides, the synergistic effect between the 3D metal oxide and 2D RGO nanosheets will effectively increase the photoxide charge carrier separation in between the photoxide charge carrier separation in between the heterogeneous interface of the nanostructures. Trapping experiment. Be similar to the before, in this trapping experiment, we can clearly see that the presence of isopropyl alcohol, IPA, which is responsible for trapping OH radicals, is during the presence of this isopropyl alcohol, the degradation efficiency is drastically decreased. And it clearly shows that OH radicals is the predominant species in this ternary nanocomposite. it is really, really interesting where we found that superoxide radicals plays as a predominant reactive species in the previous other ternary nanocomposite. But for in case, in this case, in this ternary nanostructure, OH radicals is found to be the predominant reactive species involved during photocatalytic degradation reaction process. And it is due to the bandage, appropriate bandage position of this ternary nanocomposite, which is we are going to see in that proposed photocatalytic mechanism. In this photocatalytic mechanism, the valence band and conduction band positions, bandage positions of a light absorbing metal oxide nanostructures were calculated by using UVDRS analysis, where it clearly shows that the valence band edge of both these metal oxide is well below the energy required for the generation of hydroxyl species. And it clearly shows that this composite has a higher ability to produce hydroxyl active species than the superoxide reactive species. When this ternary nanocomposite absorb visible light electromagnetic spectrum, absorb photons, the electrons will get excited from the valence band to conduction band of both metal oxide, and those excited electrons will not recombine to its valence band immediately. There, these excited electrons will get trapped by the adjacent conduction band of adjacent materials, like in case of PaO2, the electron which is excited from the valence band to conduction band of PaO2 will get trapped on the conduction band of CO3O4 as well as Fermi level of reduced graphene oxide. And so, due to this trapping of electrons, the recombination will be very high, as well as the production of hydroxyl radicals and superoxide radicals will also very, very high. Conclusion. In summary, the successful deposition of cobalt oxide and titanium dioxide nanocomposite on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanosheet is obtained by a simple two-step solvothermal technique by altering the surface charge of reactants. The morphological elemental mapping and optical analysis confirms the construction of ternary nanostructures with the prim deposition of a binary metal oxide on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanosheets with several nano channels for efficient transportation of photoisolated charged particles. The enhancement in visible light absorption in ternary nanocomposite is due to the effective transportation of photoisolated electrons on the surface of reduced graphene oxide field, which confirmed by using a UVDRS analysis. The photocatalytic degradation efficiency of ternary nanocomposite is found to be almost 100% for against both tetracycline and ibuprofen organic model pollutant molecules after in 70 minutes of degradation experiment. The reactive species trapping experiment clearly shows that both hydroxyl radicals and holes plays a major role in the degradation of pharmaceutical molecules in presence of ternary nanocomposite. The high efficient photocatalytic photoisolated charge transfer process in the ternary nanocomposite provides a new insight for the preparation of heterojunction between 2D, 3D nanostructure with effective suppression of charge recombination. Yeah. Now I will go for an overall conclusion. The summary of our research and the future work is discussed in this slide, that in our research, the reduced graphene oxide based ternary nanocomposite can be successfully prepared by simple solvothermal and hydrothermal technique. That in addition to that, the major thing in our research is we have successfully embedded those metal oxide on the surface of reduced graphene oxide nanostructures. The formation of ternary nanocomposites were confirmed by using several techniques like XRB, FTAR, HRTEM, and SPS analysis. And the UVDRS analysis showed the shift of band gap energy to higher wavelength in novel ternary photoactive system. The shift of band gap energy to higher wavelength, it shows that in higher wavelength, the visible light region will be in a higher wavelength where in between 350 to 600, 650 nanometers, where our ternary nanostructure covers in this region. And so the visible light absorption ability of this nanostructure is also very high. The SEM and TEM analysis reflected the morphology of the morphological properties of prepared catalysis. The application of ternary nanocomposite against the degradation of pharmaceutical molecules are found to be very efficient. The reuse and ternary nanocomposite may save high energy and cost. This may be considered to be advantageous over the problem, which is a mainly solid residue associated with the reduced graphene oxide nanostructure. Summary of our research, in which we deal with RGO based ternary nanocomposite. Here we can clearly see that the formation of a heterojunction between 2D, 3D, and 2D, which is in 4% of ferric oxide with 3% of RGO nano sheets. In GC3N4 nanosheets shows a very high degradation efficiency, where it degrades almost 100% of tetracycline organic pollutant molecules in 40 minutes of time.
Good night.
Ongoing work on our future work. Professor, did you raise anything? Did you raise any question?
No, yet. I think you better finish, and then we can proceed to the further step. And
yes,
let's carry on, my
it
dear.
It is the friend. Last slide.
Yes.
Yes, it is the last slide.
I can see that.
The ongoing and future work of our research is a higher order optimization of nanocomposite for better photocatalytic performance and detailed study on photocatalytic reaction mechanism. And construction of 1D, 2D nanocomposite for better charge separation and transmission efficiency, the identification of intermediates formed during degradation of organic molecules, and discovery of new synthesized strategy to reduce the length of synthesis reaction process. And these are the research articles which is related to our research, which we published in the international journals in collaboration with Professor Roberto Acevedo, under the guidance of Professor P. M. Andres. These are the research articles which we published in the last 3 years. I think I finished my... these are the paper presented in National and International Conference.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Well, thanks to you. Well, you see, we have here a nice webinar by Dr. Chanavas, and I would like very much, on behalf of organized committee, to thank him for his kindness to deliver this webinar. This webinar is going to be in YouTube, LinkedIn, and Facebook during the morning. Here in Santiago is 15 past 11 a.m. And therefore, I could say about 12 or midday, where all this material is going to be online. I would like to thank very much once again to Dr. Chanavas. I know that he has done a great effort to deliver this talk. And well, just once again, a great guy. Now, Professor Ambarasan and well, you are more than welcome to start, and Carlos as well. To start, if you have any question or something to add, or whatever suggestion you can make.
Okay, may I raise one question, Professor?
Yes, please, go ahead.
Dr. Shanawas.
Yes, Professor.
Can you hear my voice, Shanawas?
Yes, Professor, clearly. Yes, Professor, I can hear you.
Okay, or a simple and a difficult question I want to ask you.
Yes.
Your work is directly impact to wastewater studies, right?
Yes.
That means photocatalytic degradation of organic pollutants in wastewater.
Yes, right. Yeah.
So your work is relevant to environmental aspect.
Yes, Professor, exactly.
So this is associated with which sector of environmental aspect? I mean, it is relevant to globally, regionally, or locally.
Yeah, Professor. It's a really a great question. Where this kind of catalytic system, this kind of purification system, we can install these things in the industries, in all the industries which delivers the organic pollutants, especially like pharmaceutical industries and textile industries across globe. We tested against these organic pollutant molecules to understand the efficiency of these ternary nanostructures, and it doesn't mean that it will not work with any other organic pollutants. It clearly gives an overview of our ternary nanocomposite, how it will deal with the specific organic pollutants. And so we can clearly understand that its efficiency on the degradation of organic pollutants, and for other kind of pollutants in other countries or other regions, we can further study about that, how it is behaving, especially in metal organic pollutants, something like that, metal organic dyes and those things. And so I believe this we can use this in not only in regionally, but all over the globe.
You mean globally?
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Carlo, would you like to ask something?
I have no questions. Thank you. But anyway, I want to give my sincere congratulations to Dr. Shabana. I think it was a very complete, rigorous work. And I hope we can get rapidly good applications. So far, anyway, we see that there are some very promising. Thank you again for the invitation and for the conference.
Well, actually, I think the conference has been very, very good indeed. And what he has done is a great survey of the work he's been doing for many, many years. And also, it is interesting because at the very end, in the last slide, he mentioned clearly what he's pointing towards in the very near future as far as research is concerned, which means that Chanava is very active and he's looking into the future, which is very important. And this is something that I wish that everybody could do just the same. The future of the world, the future of the people, it was to increase the quality of life of people means more research, more activity, more hard work, and something which is very understanding, which is something very important, is a better understanding between us. So, Chanava, thank you very much indeed. And please do pass on my regard, love and affection to all your family and to all of my friends in India, which is a lovely country. And I hope that I shall be able to visit you in the very near future. Well, thank you very much indeed. Professor Ambarasan, my regard to your family once again, to your wife and children. I hope they are doing very well. The both of them, I think, that are studying medicine. And Carlos, please cheer up and keep it up.
And, thank you very much.
I'm going to write to you very, very soon.
Okay.
It has been a real pleasure. So, well, all my affection to you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor.
We shall
thank
see
you very much.
Thank you, one and all.
We shall see very soon. Bye. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye to everybody. Have a nice day.
Yes. Bye, my friends.
Bye.